I don't know what's going on. It's going to record, but it won't stay on. Oh no, it's like the live recording doesn't want to go. Please don't do this to me. I have such a good show set for you today. Something is going on with the software. Don't do this to me! Don't do this to me! I need to... I can't... Woo! Unbelievable. Is it going now? Oh my God, please just go. Please just tell me it's going. All right, guys, I'm going to try. I don't know. I can't figure this out. I'm not a genius. I have a software that keeps glitching on me, and I can't, I'm trying to figure out my damnedest to fix it, but it's very hard. And just when it seems to get rolling, I'm sorry if it keeps going, but I'm going to try. Nightmare here, technical nightmare. The streaming just keeps stopping on my end, and I have a full show for you guys, and I'm kind of sweating it. I'm kind of sweating right now, but let's just cross our fingers that this will work. I think everybody's on the internet maybe, and it's just glitching it. I don't know. I'm so sorry. William, you're absolutely right. I do need leave on right now. I need my, like, here we go. Hold on. Let's see if this is working. Are we there? Are we there? Oh my God, is it working? Please, Jesus. Ave Maria, Luciano Pavarotti. Help a nice French Czechoslovakian Italian girl down. Are we there? Oh my God, can everybody just, can we just all cross our fingers for a second? I am sweating. Look at the sweat that's on my forehead. I am sweating. Can we just have a glass of sip over that? Oh my Lord. I can't guarantee that it's gonna stay. I really can't. I'm doing the best that I can on very little knowledge. Cheers. Salute. Salute to you. Ashley Gardner, I put pants on too. Okay, are we there? Can you? Okay, you can see the hat. Holy smokes, I'm sweating. I'm sweating like I just threw down. Oh. Chris and Rob, you're in the house. Heather Dag, salute, salute to you. Mamma mia, mamma mia. So basically, I'm just going to tell you that at any point this freaking thing could crash again. And if it does, if it all crashes tomorrow, I love you. I love you. Oh my God. All right. Hello, soul sister. Randy Bubala. You're here. Bubala. We're in the house. Oh, thank God. If you missed the first 10 minutes, it wasn't pretty. It's kind of like me waking up in the morning. Lady McCoy, do we have any slapback? Is Karen Leclerc, my sound woman here? The Siva's in the house. Andiamo, andiamo. I'm dying over here too. Oh, Indy Eaton in the house. Indy Eaton in the house. Microsoft is throwing me over a table like it's bitch right now, Anne-Marie McCoy. I have pains in my asshole for the first 10 minutes of this show. All right, I have genuine pains in my asshole right now. And if that ain't Italian, I don't know what is. Oh, God. All right. Do you like my Italian music for you today? Welcome to the Italian edition of Facebook Live. Internet hammers. So, Abby Levin! Thank you for praying for my asshole. I appreciate that. We all need to pray for something these days. So, why not add my asshole to the list? So, I have a jam-packed show for you. I have so much stuff. Yes, I am in Montauk. I am from my basement in my Montauk, and my dog just opened the door, and I have to close it because Mommy is in her special bubble right now. So, hold on and pray that this doesn't stop anything. Macho, always ruining it. So I got my pasta from the Mancinellis. Danielle Mancinelli, thank you very much over here. And the wine. Cheers to the Mancinellis. The fucking dog just came in again. Again, I'm leaving the door open. All right, you know what? No, I'm going to set him up and he can sit. And he can watch my Italian special. Go lie down, you bad dog. Go lie down. Never ends. Never ends. All right. So I thought we would start. Oh, Mr. Silver! Hello there, my darling. I was so glad. So what are we eating right now? What do we got? What do we got out there? Anybody? Anybody got? I got homemade Italian food delivered on my doorstep. We got any eggplant parmesan? Huh? Oh my God. That's religious. That is religious right there. I don't care where you live. I live a block away from the Mancinellis. That's all I care about right now. Homemade first time. Sicilian chicken, white wine. What do we got? Baked squash, ziti, parmesan. Oh, how vegetarian of you. John's driving. Go get toast tonight. All right, bad salmon in the case of the shit. That's not Italian. Inda, I thought you were gonna grill. What happened to the big talk about grilling? Karen Leclerc, do I got the slap back today? Pink vodka and shrimp sauce. Thank you, Adrian Martin. There we go, some real food. Risotto. Thank you, Ashley Gardner. Linguine with Italian chicken sausage. Do I expect anything less than you from you, Sivas? Spinach ravioli from Bambino's coming right up, sir. How you doing? All right, good. Much better. You made a homemade pasta. Well, you had all fucking day to do that, didn't you? So, okay. It better be good. Grilled corn nuts. Thanks, Inda. You know, it's not a good day unless you can grill something, is it? All right, I'm taking one more bite of this because it's legitimately insane. Any other Italian food out there? All right. Dimples. What's up? Annie Rush! Scotto spaghetti and me. Oh. Annie, you can cook. I'm sorry to talk while I eat, but it is a live broadcast. Hey, Tony, how you doing? Chicken cacciatore. All right, well, listen, we all have our food, right? And even though it's a live broadcast, and God help me if I screw up the goddamn thing here and I stop it again. But I thought this could get us in the mood. I thought this might get us in the mood. All right, you ready? Let's all just take a moment together and watch the Masters, shall we?
We're going to ask the audience, and we are going to join in applauding both orchestras here tonight.
I think that's swell.
Really, magnificent job.
John Dancy and the wonderful
and Quincy Jones, who conducted for me, and George Rhodes.
Would you stand up, ladies and gentlemen? George Rhodes. Michael Silver, stand up there. Mr. Quincy Jones, directing there. Oh, you told him that?
Well, you know, you have to explain it a lot because we all look alike.
Let us pray. Dearly beloved.
Oh, excuse me.
Hey, could we all finish by doing one
not
number?
Can we?
May we, not can we.
May we, never in the same
way. May we, Sam, not can we.
Fight.
Oh, if I find out that's true, my heart is broken.
May we? Can we?
May we?
Could we? John, may we?
Yes, sir.
May we? That's French.
Okay.
All right.
We can use that.
Well, what about doing a number together?
Yeah, now you're talking.
Could we do Birth of the Blues together and each person take
Why
a little
not,
bit?
Sam?
Gee, that sounds like a swell idea. I'll get Mickey and Judy and we'll build a barn. When's the last time you seen an Italian cut? I'm gonna cut him. You know, he touches me one more time. He ain't got no chance.
I'd like to get out of this act if you don't mind. I gotta catch a plane.
Yeah, want the mics closer?
You want the mics closer?
Closer.
All
right.
It'll be my guess.
Then we'll just be one.
We don't need this?
We don't need this, huh?
I thought it was separate but equal.
It off. It's my number. If you don't mind.
Oh, I ain't gonna fight with all your troops.
Well, I tell you, if we ever get in the lead, you two cats are first.
Would you give me
no way, baby. Go ahead.
Give me a keynote, George, please.
Anybody wants, put on my track.
There's a gangster sleeping upstairs. Easy.
Quiet, Sam. Subtlety, baby.
All right, sweet cakes. Oh, my goodness gracious. They.
No, don't, no. The guy in the back can't hear you. Go ahead, a little more, baby. Loosen up.
They.
They.
You may be my leader, but I'm going to punch you right in your mouth.
You tell us.
Oh, they. That's
hey.
All right.
I got to catch a train sooner. Yeah.
What are you complaining about? I got to go to a bar mitzvah in a minute. They heard the breeze through the trees.
Jail came a whale from a down-hearted frail, and they called that the start of the moon.
From a whippoorwill high on a hill.
How about that?
They till it's a blue note.
Get off the stage.
And then they nursed it. And they rehearsed it.
How does it feel to sit in the back of the bus?
Then I came up the news that the Southland really gave birth.
Let's give Dean a chance.
It's something.
Everybody, they nursed it. They rehearsed it. And really, they came up with the news. That's the Southland.
Shut up. Shut up. Hold on a second. Now I have to figure out why I have that slapback. Okay, hold on. I got it now. I think I got it now. There we are. There we are. Everyone can hear me, right? Sorry that I have to even ask you. Oh. I don't know about you, but I just kind of need that. I needed that. I thought I have things today that I could probably get sued for by sharing them, but I don't really care because knock yourself out. Have fun stealing my shitty Cadillac that won't start on a March morning. But I, you know, what I've made for you today is a bunch of things that I hope that you'll enjoy and that I'll enjoy too. I'm going to just be really honest with you. I was very sick earlier in this week. I got sick yesterday on Sunday, and I was sick for 5 days. I almost didn't do this broadcast, but I started feeling better. Obviously, it was like the cough and the fever and all that shit that you think it is. But I don't want to dwell on that. I want to dwell on the fact that I'm good now and that we're here together and that I did what I needed to do and rested. My husband took great, great care of me and my family did too. And I rested at home. And I put this show together in about 2 to 3 days, just calling friends and asking them, giving them prompts. Don't worry, Rich. I'm fine. I haven't been outside for like 2 weeks, so you don't have to worry about me. And I'm fine now, right? I seem fine. But I'm just going to be honest that I really couldn't, I can't sing. I don't have the energy to sing, and I've had a long week. So instead, I've put together a bunch of really great live performances that have happened over, and one of them was a new song that we debuted in at the Fireside Sessions with my very good friend. I can't even really call her a friend, honestly. I'm a little emotional. I call her, she's my sister. She's my chosen sister. And that's Randy. She's on right now. And I love you, Rand. I do. You bring so much joy into my life. Anyway, here is a photo, a video of Randy and I. Sorry. Playing a new song that I had just written in January.
So I wrote a new blues song, and we played it for the first time last night. So you're gonna hear it the second time. It's called Born Broken Hearted. Everybody warm and toasty?
Oh yeah.
You're so behaved. We're gonna have to shake that.
Oh my God, it felt like, hold on, oh, wait, what did I do now? I did something wrong. Skippity-doo-dah, skippity-day. What are we going to do? I mean, we're all going to be okay, but I just, when I see that, it makes me miss playing with my band and connecting with you all, and I think it's just so beautiful that we can be here in this space and have this technology to be together. I'm going to feed into that. I'm going to roll right into that. I'm not going to get too mushy. I think the red wine might make me cry. I'm not a, you know, I haven't been drinking a lot. And I think there's a chance for more tears in this live broadcast. I think there definitely is. So this next thing that I'm going to play for you is so funny because it's another sister from another mister, Kate Muth from Neopolitical Cowgirls. I have to find this. Shit, I need my glasses. And I gave her the prompt. It was the Italians. And she threw this out. We have two skits from her tonight. With August Gladstone and the phenomenal, phenomenal Josh Gladstone, who is one of the main guys at Guildhall, but is just, you know, all August I'm getting to know, but Kate and Josh are probably the artery into the acting out here. I mean, I just love, I'm stuttering over my words because I'm having a hard time finding it. All right. So anyway, I thought it would be very funny to have redheaded Italians. And so this is what I just said, swear words from redheaded Italians. And this is what my friends did yesterday in a very short amount of time. And Kate kicked the camera with her boot, which just makes it even better as far as I'm concerned. Ladies and gentlemen, the redheaded Italians.
Hey. Hi. We're the red-headed Italians here.
Buongiorno.
Buongiorno. Damo. Damo?
What's it with the boots on the table?
So we're the red-headed Italians. Don't know why we're the redheaded Italians, but Nancy wanted us to be the redheaded Italians. I guess we're a rare breed. Cheers. We're here to teach you a few of our favorite Italian terms. I hope your children aren't in the room because this is probably not the best time for them to be watching a video on Italian terms.
These are filthy expressions that are used in the Italian language.
Every person should know these.
In dirty Italian, you don't say a place is far away. Instead, you say it's in the ass, in culo.
Italians don't say something is done wrong. They say it's done as a dog's dick. A cazzo di cane.
When something is obvious, Italians don't say, duh. They say, thank the dick.
Grazie al cazzo. In dirty Italian, you don't say, go fuck yourself. Rather, you say, go shit yourself. Andare a cagare.
And if you're very scared, you shit in your hands. Cagare in mano.
In dirty Italian, you're not simply sick of a situation. Instead, you have your balls full. Avere I coglioni pieni.
In Italian, you don't suck at something. Instead, you're a hand job.
Una pipa. And if something really sucks, you can say, it sucks to the dick. Fa schifo al cazzo.
In dirty Italian, when something or someone is annoying, They're breaking the balls. Rompere la palla.
And when someone takes advantage of you, they shit out of the bowl. Cagare fiori dalla tazza.
When something goes wrong, you take it in the ass. Say, prendere nel culo.
More specifically, we say at the end of the day, the cucumber always goes in the produce seller's
ass.
Ass.
Gira cetera rigiara il ceretiolo va in culo al ortolano. So, that's our lesson to you for today. Congratulations to you, Miss Alice N. Arrivederci.
Arrivederci. We love you.
Arrivederci. Arrivederci. Hold on, I got to do this because I know that it's going to have a feedback. Hey, rim shot. Hey now. Grazie mille, grazie mille. Ho evitato in Florence per un anno in storia di storia di arte. It just starts flowing. Can we have a toast to Kate Muth, a social? And if you're not drinking, here's a seltzer that has green on it. So my green screen's getting it. And you know, I feel deeply that it's time, if we're going to have a toast to Kate, to break out Nipple Man. I do. I feel that we've been missing. This one's going out to Ashley Gardner. Hold on a second. We can't have a broadcast without Nipple Man. This one's going out to you. Oh, which one do I go for? No. Oh, Chin Chin, Cindy Siva, Heather Dagg, Danielle Mancinelli. Hope the children aren't watching this, but mostly Kate, Josh, and August for pulling that together. I love it. It's so funny. Rolling right along with that, we're going to stick with in our community. Here's a little clip of, it's, you know what? That's a really good point. It's birthday time, which means we can all wash our fucking hands as we sing. A big happy birthday to Johnny Boy Muse, Holy Bedhead, Johnny Boy Muse, and Inda Eaton, who I missed last week. She's turning 29 again. And let's all sing happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday, Inda and Johnny, happy birthday to you. All right. Inda Eaton is one of my besties, and she sent me this video, and it is just so good. This is from a past show. Hope you enjoy it.
It's one of my most joyful moments when we can all sing together. I mean, I'm such a fan. Nancy, I'm such a fan. When we do sing, it's weird. We have as much fun as you think we are. It's lovely.
I always hope you're having as much fun as we do, right?
When they're paying their bills, they're having more fun than us.
That's great.
That's what I was thinking. I wrote this special song. We have fun when we're on the mic, but we don't have fun paying the bills. Money! Give me money! Got no food in the cupboard, I ain't spent no money. But I got a song in my heart, but I got no money. But I'll take love, baby, anytime. I need some whiskey in the corner, but I got no money. Oh, them cupboards are kind of dry. But my neighbor's got the money. Oh, but my husband's got the money. So, you know, this is going to be our new Hampton song. It's called My Neighbor's. It's because my neighbor's got the money. Here we go. Because my neighbor's got the money.
freaking teeth, Kate.
What she got? 70 years old, and she's asking, who's got the love, baby?
Maybe it's too late. My neighbors came to town. They got the money and they never are around. Except when I don't need them in the backyard. And it's coming summer. And now I see the face. And they got the money.
Dollars and I had a few dimes, and I know just where my heart is gonna go.
All right.
You don't need to tell a woman just how she gonna get by. 'Cause she wakes up every morning, baby, and then she gonna survive. She got the love.
You're beautiful every day. Look for someone that's gonna love you. He'll make you feel real fine. Don't matter whether you got money or not, as long as everything's fine.
Neighbors got the money. But I am working on a new song. Gosh darn it. Hold on. I'm working on a new song. It goes something like this. It goes, money don't need nothing if you're dead. Money don't need nothing if you're dead. So keep going to your yoga classes and keep taking toilet passes, 'cause money don't mean nothing if you're dead. Yeah, it's good. It reminds me of something. I've had that issue before when I've written new songs and they're like, you do realize that you've just rewritten Blowing in the Wind. In this case, I think it might be like a Cheerios commercial or something like that, or like some old
Hey, you know who we have? We have so much for you. How's everybody doing? You still with me? You still? Give me a little hearts. You got a little hearts or a little thumbs? Chimps, you still there? I know this is delayed. Hold on a second. I have so much stuff for you guys. I have so much stuff. I just don't even know. Can we just take a little Italian? There we go. Oh, we got to take a little Italian break because this is the Italian thing. And I am going to do a play-by-play with you at home watching this. Let's just all watch this because this is one of my favorite scenes from Godfather. And I'm going to just, I'm going to be both. I'm going to react, but I may also act like watching this with my husband. Hold on, here we go. Oh.
That I cannot do. I'll give you anything you ask.
Oh, don't go to him on
We've
his
We've known each other many years, but this is the first time he ever came to the Council for help.
You are so fucked.
I can't remember the last time that he invited me to your house for a cup of coffee. Even though my wife is godmother to your only child.
She's the godmother to your child, and you don't invite him for coffee?
You wanted my friendship. And you were afraid to be my dad.
I didn't want to get into trouble.
I understand.
Oh, he is so fucked.
He found paradise in America. Had a good trade, made a good living, police protected you, and there were courts of law. He didn't need a friend like
me. You tell him, Godfather. You tell him.
But now you come to me and you say, Don Corleone, and give me justice. But you don't ask for respect. You don't offer friendship.
You don't offer him friendship.
You don't even think to call me Godfather.
You don't call him Godfather. He's doing shit for you.
He said you come into my house on the day my daughter's to be married.
You came on his daughter's wedding day?
Money.
And asked him to murder someone? What, are you a fucking idiot?
That is not justice. Your daughter's still alive.
Dude.
I'm going to suffer then.
Kill him now. Kill him.
She suffers. How much shall I pay?
Oh my God, you're offering him money? Holy shit. That's just, look at him. He's getting up. He's like, I don't even want part of this. He just offered him money on his daughter's wedding day.
Buonasera.
Buonasera.
Buonasera. What have I ever done to make you treat me so disrespectful?
Oh my God.
You'd come to me in friendship. And the scum that ruined your daughter would be suffering this very day. And if by chance an honest man like yourself should make enemies, then he would become my enemies.
I'm so scared.
And then they would fear you.
Kiss his fucking ring, dude. Kiss his fucking ring. Be my friend. Dude, invite him to fucking coffee. That's all he wants.
Good.
Thank God. Thank you.
Someday, and that day may never come, I'll call upon you to do a service for you.
Okay. Okay.
But, until that day, accept this justice as a gift on my daughter's wedding day.
Grazie. Yes.
Grazie. Good. Oh, dude, kiss the ring, bro. Kiss the ring. I mean, what do you just, you know, I think it goes to a lot. How enjoyable was that, by the way? Now I want to watch The Godfather. Is everybody with me? Carls, how you doing? Uh-oh, what did I do? No, we can't. Respect the Godfather. Could you hear me talking while, just as curiosity, could you hear me talking while that was going on? Oh no, seriously? Oh no. Oh my God. Awesome. Did I get? Damn. I'm totally ready to go to jail. I'm totally ready to go to jail. Can you hear me now? 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 Hold on a second. I'm totally breaking the law. Damn. Okay. Okay. Hold on. Here we go. Here we go. Am I still going long? Am I still going? Hold on. Oh my God. I'm so sorry. I totally did break the law. You know what? Come and fucking get me. Come and get me. You know why? Because if breaking the law is watching Marlon Brando seeing the best singing Godfather, I'm just so sorry you missed my commentary about, I was just leading him through it. But I'm so sorry that you got blacked out. I can't see what you see because I'm in real time here and I'm like 20 seconds ahead of you. So I apologize for that. It was really funny. This is a replay of it. Okay. This is, oh my God, kiss the ring. Kiss the ring. All he wanted was for you to drive over and ask him for coffee. And you come on his daughter's wedding day and you ask him to murder someone. What the fuck are you thinking? So that's basically the last 4 minutes in like 30 seconds. That's what that happened. That's what happened. All right. Let's break about Mipple Man. This one's going to Colleen Palooba. How you doing? Boop, 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 boop. Yeah. No, you know what? Let's go with Primavera. Because spring is here. Spring is coming. There's for the guys saying, oh, look, I got yours too. Not gender neutral here. I just open to everybody squeezing everyone's nipple on my YouTube live. Where am I going to go? Where am I going to go? You know where I'm going to go? I think I'm going to Haley London. I think it's time for the Haley, the health dragon. That's what I think. Ladies and gentlemen, for a second week in a row, it is my extreme pleasure to offer you some health advice from my good friend, Haley London, Haley the health dragon.
Quarantine queen. Now we're sharing nothing. Oh, buongiorno, ladies and gentlemen. Nice to see you here. Once again, your friendly neighborhood transition dragon. No, I'm the nutrition dragon, actually, sent here by our friend Nancy Atlas. Clearly not the mental health dragon right now, but that's okay. So today, in our Italian festival of the evening, hosted by Nancy Atlas, we're going to explore the importance of good nutrition during a pandemic, social distancing, quarantine situation that we find ourselves in for days and days and days. So vegetables are really important and nutrition is really important, but nutrition can be confusing. So just to let you know how confusing it can be, we'll do a brief history of the nutrition of the egg over 45 years. Okay, hold on. 1970, eggs are great, Rocky drinks them raw, yay! 1980, don't eat eggs, eggs are really bad, cholesterol bad, kill you. 1990, egg whites are great, eat egg whites in everything, don't eat the yolk. 2000, the yolks are brain food, how could you be throwing the yolks away? 2010, turns out maybe foods with cholesterol don't actually raise your body's cholesterol or contribute to heart disease. We don't really know. 2020, it's genetics. Eat your fucking eggs. Stop guzzling bacon. You're all getting alpha gal anyway on the East End. Great. Okay, so enough about that. But what we do know is vegetables never go out of style. So juicing is a great thing you could do right now to keep your immunity up. So shall we make a juice together? So over here I have my juice ingredients and I just realized I don't have a juicer. So as we will, I'm not very prepared in this pandemic, but invention is the mother of necessity and they don't call me McGurver for nothing, but I have a muddler. So muddling works fine, right? Instead of juicing, we'll muddle. So just add some of our handy dandy cucumber. Chop that up real fine, because you know we gotta muddle. Gotta muddle through this together. Maybe a little greens, a little spinach, a little kale. I'm just gonna muddle that. We're gonna muddle that into a nice pulp. Oops, I've over muddled. Sometimes may happen in some of these disastrous situations. So let's just hope there's no glass shards in there, and let's just switch to this actual device that's meant for muddling, which isn't a glass. And we'll muddle, and we'll muddle. And you know, it's really important to add a liquid. So when you're making a juice, you can add a juice. So let's go get some of our orange juice, make us a healthy little greens and orange juice. Turns out I don't have any orange juice, but I seem to have some gin. So I think that'll do. It's important to pour out your shots so you know exactly how much you're getting. So just pour and hold the shot glass and just imagine, you know, the amount that's supposed to be correct. And just pour whatever you need right now. Pour an ounce for every day you've been in your house if you need to. Pour an ounce for every person you haven't hugged. Just keep pouring. And you know, I think this juice now that's really liquefying, nice and well. And you know, I think every good, healthy juice could use a splash of vermouth. You know, this is how they sell them at Provisions and all the healthy juice places. No? Okay, so we poured our juice, we've muddled our juice, and let's get our drink beverage cup ready. So we have a nice little rocks glass, not our normal juice container. Let's get rid of this glass and, you know, make our juice fun today for a fun nutritional edge. These disco ice cubes are a really fun way to brighten up any day in quarantine. So I like to put my disco ball right in my rocks glass and get my strainer going for my healthy, nutritious vegetable cocktail. Strain that right over my disco ball. And here we go, my third juice of the day. A little garnish. Salud to your health. May you be healthy. May you be positive. May we get through this, and may we have the biggest cuddle pile in the history of cuddle piles. Mm. Woo!
Salud, Hal. Thank you so much for that. That was really, really awesome. Thank you to all of my friends, to Inda, to Kay, to Haley, to Abby Levin. Last week, she's our weather. Abby Brookalina took a week off this week, but she's hopefully going to come back next week. She's been looking into adopting a cat. The world is... All right, so do you ever come up with an idea? And then you, oh my God, look, I have Mancinelli sauce on the side of my mouth right now. You ever come up with an idea? And part of being an artist is kind of trying to control what, especially in these times, it's very, very hard. What images go out and making sure your product is great. And I had a little skit idea. And I did it, and it's so incredibly bad, but it's so bad that I have decided to share it with you, because I'm getting to the point very, very quickly, kind of like when the people come to arrest me for trying to put clips of The Godfather up on my thing. I'm sorry about that again. Not to them, but I'm sorry to you that you had to wait. I'm just getting to to the point where I'm like, who cares, right? So I'm letting go of my quality factor, and I present to you an interview that a local broadcaster did of finding out the current state of superheroes.
Hi, this is Ryan Williams reporting on the current state of our superheroes. Speaking with us now, you all know him, you all love him, Batman!
Hey, everybody. Oh, hi, everybody. It's Super Clam. Super Clam Lady. Clam Lady. I was Shuck a Girl last week, but I've been homeschooling my children for 2 weeks, and I very quickly became Clam Lady. Second tier, we got Taco Man, Bad Chucky. There's a whole bunch of us you don't know about.
Clam Lady? You're not a superhero. I've never heard of you.
I whip my head really fast, and they become...
Yeah, that's not happening. I don't know why, but it's shutting down my stream. Hold on a second. Hold on. Okay, are we there? Are we back? Oh, my God. No, that was my own live thing, but it was shutting down my thing, so I think... Hold on a second. Can you see me? Hold on a second. Can you see me now? Clam Lady took me down. Okay, thank you, Ellen. Clam Lady took me down. All right, thank you. My improv of my superhero, Clam Lady, obviously does not like my, hold on a second. Oh my goodness, doing my best here. It does not like my streaming capabilities, so I'm sorry about that. And I'm not going to, but we are going to try our good friend now, Mr. Lenny DeFina.
Hello, everybody. My name is Lenny DeFina, and I'd like to thank you for watching this, if anybody is. I don't know. I was invited by Nancy Atlas. Name rings a bell. And she was looking for an Italian. I got a phone call that, hey, Lenny, I'm looking for an Italian. I got a message, and I thought it was for maybe some mozzarella or some pasta ciotta or capocella or whatever. But I happened to speak to Nancy, and she told me, no, it's for a little thing she's doing here. And she needs an Italian to sing some songs. And I said, well, why not? This is the best time right now. I'm always sitting at my piano exploring the new wonders of music. And we're going to do a couple of songs for you, a little old-time songs. And I have here tons of orchestrations that I used to use with saxophones, clarinets, trombones, oboes, drums. But we can't use that today with live instruments. So we're going to use the old karaoke system here to try to get some tunes into you. And we're going to start with a wonderful, wonderful tune that... Dino Martino sang many moons ago, and it's one of my favorite songs. Mr. Joe Gaviola gave me this song 20-some-odd years ago to sing. And I happen to love it. Here we go. Dino Martino. How lucky can one guy be? I kissed her and she kissed me. Like the fella once said, ain't that a kick in the head? The room was completely black. I hugged her and she hugged back. Like the sailor said, quote, ain't that a hole in the bone? My head keeps spinning. I go to sleep and keep grinning. If this is not the beginning, my life is gonna be beautiful. I've got sunshine enough to spread, just like the fella said. Tell me quick, ain't that a kick in the head? Those are the orchestrations. Here we go. Like the fella once said, ain't that a kick in the head? One more time. Like the sailor said, quote, ain't that a hole in the bone? My head keeps spinning. I go to sleep and keep grinning. It's just like it's the beginning. My life is gonna be you.
the phone. She's telling me that we've been wed. She's picked out a king-size bed. I couldn't feel any better, or I'd be sick. Tell me quick, oh, ain't love a kick? Hey, tell me quick, ain't that a kick in the head? Oh man, the old orchestrations, I tell you, there's nothing like brass. When you got brass, think about the other word. You got brass, 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 and it's wonderful. And witnessed that and lived that in a long time, being in Vegas, Reno, Tahoe. There was nothing like playing or singing with a live brass orchestra. I'd like to just say hello to Massimo Funato, a very dear friend of mine. I just got off the phone with him this morning. He's in Rome, Italy. Very dear friend in the Via Condotti area. And he asked me how we're doing here in America, and I said, we're just doing what we have to do. We're following the rules, and he conveyed his well wishes to America. He's also a friend of mine on Facebook, a very dear friend, Massimo Funato. Reach out to him, say hi. He'd love to hear from everybody. Anyway, my friends, I'm going to do one more. We can't do anything without leaving out the master, the chairman of the board himself, Mr. Frank Sinatra. And this song is for all you people out there. You're being inside, you're with your family, you're with your wives. What a wonderful thing. You're with your family. This is a time you want to go outside and maybe sing this song to yourself. Don't sing it to anybody else, but it's a great tune. Frank Sinatra. Got you under my skin. I have got you deep in the heart of me. So deep in my heart that you're really a part of me. I've got you under. I tried so not to give in. I said to myself, this affair, it never will go so well. But why should I try to resist when, darling, I am no soldier? I've got you under my. I would sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you dear, in spite of the warning voice that comes through the night and repeats how it yells in my ear. Don't you know, you fool, you're never gonna win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. Just the thought of you makes me stop just before I begin. Cause I've got you under my skin. Here we go, this is what I'm talking about. The big brass, the trombones, the saxophones. This is when they say, bring it up from the rear, Joe. Okay, here we go. One, two, one, two, one, two. Here we go! One, two, three, and... Come with might for the sake of having you near, in spite of the warning voice comes through the night. It repeats how it yells in my ear. Don't you know, you fool?
Cause the thought of you makes me stop just before I begin. Cause I've got you under my skin. And you grab me under my skin. A big thank you to Nancy Atlas for putting this together. I thank you all. God bless. We'll get through this together. And God bless America.
Our first gig that we played was actually hysterical because I had 8 original songs and I was so idealistic. And it was at the Stephen Talk House. And we get up there, it was a $5 cover, and we play our 8 songs. And it was a Friday night. And the bartender, lead bartender, comes up to me, says, why are you packing up? And I was like, well, I played my 8 songs, and that's what I got. And he's like, dude, it's Friday night. You can't pack up. And I'm like, those are 8 original songs. You know how long it took me to write those? And he's like, well, what am I going to tell everybody? You're supposed to play until 3 o'clock, and it's like 10:30. And I go, if anybody has a problem with spending $5 to hear 8 original songs, tell them to come talk to me. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a song about a red-headed lassie. She's more man than you'll ever be, more woman than you ever done. And there's a few things that she ain't seen yet, but baby, you are the one. She finally needs to be a little carefree with the life that she got left. She's gonna dump your ass, make boat to cash, and drive your truck out west. They call her Tequila, Tequila Sheila. She drinks 2 shots, and then she's a thief, and you don't know her, you know her. River. Her mama taught her to stand still. Mama taught her be kind to others. Mama taught her to kill. She got 2 soft babies. She's a snake. She's a charmer. She's the flesh. She's the cherry. She's the pit. You can kiss her hand or kiss her ass. Kiss her grits. They call her Tequila, Tequila Sheila. She drinks 2 shots and then she's a beer. And you don't know her. You know her. Southern comfort, honey, and Southern hospitality. And if you scream the word, she'll shake a pigeon just for free, you know. Hair is red and her lips are red and her eyes, they twinkle like stars. She wears a crown in town as a queen of the hometown bar. They call her Tequila, Tequila Sheila. She drinks 2 shots and she's a good bee.
But you're always getting it wrong.
I do not know why. And I cannot figure out, I can't figure it out right now. And I'm starting to get that lovely patina that you get from red wine when you've been drinking it, which I haven't had in quite some time. Can we have a toast? And if you're not drinking at home, please break out a seltzer. You know, some of the things that we've been thinking about, I thought about this the other day, and maybe we could come up with this now because we have a really, really good... Sarah, you're so fucking late. It's like you're an hour in, dude. I'm moving on to seltzer for a little bit because it's just going to get ugly, and I don't need this immortalized. Oh, Bill Becker. Hello, my friend. Hold on. Oh, I got the goddamn slapback. I got Karen Leclerc in the back of my head every time I hear slapback. Okay, better. Hi, everyone. A cheers with seltzer to any of those people out there that aren't drinking through this, because I think being sober is such a noble, noble thing, and I fucking bow down because I am not, and I mean that with all seriousness. So cheers to you with my seltzer. All right, so I got my posse here. I got Sarah, I got Bill, I got Ellen, I got Inda, I got Kate. We have a very big decision to make here right now. Excuse me. Back in the 1400s, when there was the plague, a lot of you probably already know this already, but if not, I'll give you a little history course. One of the first signs of the plague was a cough. Was a hachu. And so they said, God bless you. And so now we have COVID-19, and I'm trying not to talk about it too much because this is a head break, but I'm thinking that we need something better to say when people cough, because when you live in New York and you hear somebody cough, it's kind of, it's a double-edged sword right now. It really, really is, because it's, you don't want anybody coughing, right? But if you think of it, you take this in a different direction, it's a little bit of a wet dream to be able to say to somebody, what the fuck, when they cough, because deep down, for years and years and years, I've always wanted to do that. Prior to it, is like when someone's like, and you're like, are you serious? When you're in an airport or something? So now is our chance to embrace being able to tell people when they cough, you know, deep down what we always wanted to tell them. And so I'm thinking we need to come up with something to say, because in the 1400s, when they said, ha-choo, it was, God bless you, because they knew that was the first sign of plague. So now we have, right? And I'm thinking, may the force be with you. What do you think? No? No, cover your mouth is not good enough. Cover your mouth is not, we need something that's going to last for all of time. We need something that, like, for 600 years from now, they're going to be able, when you cough, they're going to say, may the force be with you. Well, not with that. We don't ever want saluting. But when they mean, may the force be with you. How about that? Is that good? How about, because it's either may the force be with you or cover your fucking mouth. And so, you know, is that how we want to be remembered 500 years from now? Is that really what we want? Cover your fucking mofo, go-go. I'm also with you. All right, hold on. Let's let him hear it. Let me hear what you got. Joss likes, what the fuck? What the fuck? I like that too. And just, you got to think, you got to roll with me on this. You got to roll 500 in, yeah, yeah. No, seriously, you can look into it. I'm an art historian. People don't know that, but that's what I graduated in college. God bless you comes from the plague. I'm sorry. I don't want to be heavy. I don't. Did I not work on not being heavy? I got teary-eyed expressing my love for Randy, and then I had to pull it back because we have so much heavy that this cast every Saturday or whenever the hell we're going to do it, we're going to pick an off night because you know I'm the underdog queen. I love off nights. So everybody's going to start doing things on Saturday, and we got to pick a night. But I sneeze in Joe. Monty, I sneeze in your general direction. What's the opposite of thank you? I don't know. Okay, so what do we got? What are we coming up with? I'm sorry. I was talking so much. I wasn't reading. I'm going to read now. All right, so send me your suggestions. I'm at Chris and No Ding. Yay. You got to keep the devil inside down. That's a good one. God bless you. No, it's already been used. God bless you's already been used. May the force be with you. What the fuck? I like that. I like that. It's got a ring. It's got a ring. All right, so let me tell you something. Because I will not take no for an answer. Because I will not take... That's the last fucking time. I like that one. I like that. What do I got? What do I got for you? Let's break out Nipple Man. I miss Nipple Man. He's not here enough, this one. Oh, Nipple Man. I wasn't gonna sing, but I sing for Nipple Man. 'Cause he inspires me with his nipples. Always brings me so much joy. I don't know why. Maybe it's his conviction. Look at that. He is so convicted to squeezing his nipples. I just, You go, Nipple Man. Yeah, that's right. I know. He brings this so... Hold on. Should we have Nipple Man with a little Italian music? Hold on. Hold on. Yes. Feel the Nipple Man in the Italian music. I give to you. Yes. Yes. You know, there's other Italian, there's other Nipple Men. There really are. Hold on. Nipple Man was not the first Nipple Man. Nipple Men have been around for many years. Yes, they have. Caravaggio, Nipple Man. Nipple Boy, sorry. Did I overstep? I didn't really. He's over 16. Cover him up! Oh my God! Suddenly. He looks 17 and a half to me. Alright, let me see if I... Okay, here's Clam Lady 780. I'm literally... I re-downloaded... my horrible skit, my Clam Lady, my Batman superhero skit, to a new bitrate or whatever the hell it is. And let's see if it's gonna work. You ready?
Hi, this is Ryan Williams reporting on the current state of our superheroes. Speaking with us now, you all know him, you all love him, Batman!
Hey, everybody. Oh, hi, everybody. It's Super Clam. Super Clam Lady. Clam Lady. I was Shucka Girl last week, but I've been homeschooling my children for 2 weeks, and I very quickly became Clam Lady.
I think we're having some technical difficulties. Clam Lady?
Yeah, we're like a second tier. We're second tier. You've never heard of us because we're like a second tier. We got Taco Man, Bad Chucky. There's a whole bunch of us, you know, you don't know about. We just kind of, we're in the shadows. We're not as famous as the big guns, you know. But we're here. We're here.
Clam Lady? You're not a superhero. I've never heard of you.
I can take clams and I turn into a seagull. And then I whip my head really fast and they become, these little fuckers become like bullets. They're unbelievable. They slice you in the head. But I'm a superhero on the East End.
East End of Long Island? All right, Clam Lady. What exactly do you do?
So often what'll come in the news is that somebody's driven into a jetty or a pier in broad daylight, and you could say to yourself, what? How the hell did somebody take a boat and drive it into a pier in the middle of the day? I don't understand, with all the radar and all... Well, that's because a crazy seagull. Wah! Throw the clam, 75, 80, sometimes 90 when I'm having a good day, miles an hour, hits the head. And all the last thing that bastard, that drinking bastard sees is a seagull, a rabid seagull coming at it. at 70 miles an hour. And he takes a boat and, you know, he might have been headed for a jet ski or something. He does that and bam, he goes right into the jetty. Takes him out every time. Nobody's hurt. That's just an example of my work.
Clam Lady, are you busy right now? How have things been on the streets?
You know, I basically will be go. Oh my God. It's my brother. He's just like calling me right now. God, so stupid. All the superheroes, just, you're going to hate this, but they're partying because they're like immune to this thing. But anyway, well, listen, be safe. Don't drive your boat drunk, because you know what? I'm going to come at you and I'm going to take you out, is basically what. You're going to die and you're going to look like an idiot on top of it, because who drives a boat into a jetty? Who? In the broad daylight. I'll tell you who does it. A victim of Clam Lady. That's who. Peace out.
Well, thank you, Clam Lady. You're not who we expected, but I hope everyone on the East End is staying home and staying safe. All right, this is Ryan Williams reporting from Metropolis. Bye-bye.
You gotta love Clam Lady. Just gotta love her. I'm so glad that she finally explained why, how those boats drive into the jetty every year, because it's just, by the way, we vetoed not to show that because it was so bad. So I hope that you enjoy us baring our breasts to you. That is us baring our not perfect. It's so bad that it's good, I think. Do you enjoy Clam Lady? Maybe we'll bring her back. Maybe she could give us some tips on how to get through it. Yeah, cash is good. So listen, here's the deal. This thing, if it cuts out, you just need to tell me, all right? Because I'm doing this as I go. I'm not watching this as I go, so I don't know. But this was something when I thought of Italy. If this does work, I want you all to slow your breathing down. And if it doesn't work, I'll be right back. But I'll be watching the, I'll be watching my phone, Ellen. So text my phone if it's not, because I didn't see the messages last time when it blacked out, okay? But this is something that I grew up on, and there's a very good chance that I could have it blacked out, and I don't want that to happen to you for the full thing. So I'll be looking. Just send me little comments and reactions if it does go through, okay? Breathe deep. It's been so easy to forget joy in the last 2 weeks for me. I've been hunkering down in the reality of trying to keep my family safe and processing. And last weekend I got sick, and one of the things I told a good friend of mine who was also not so well was to go into the sun and to listen to her favorite music. When the sun comes out, we need to listen to our favorite music, or maybe that's silence if you love yoga, or maybe that's cooking. And I know we've had a lot of time. Trust me, I'm not preaching right now. I'm really not, because I know everybody has their own vibe. Let me put it to you this way. As I was coughing for 3 days, sitting in the sun, listening to Lucinda Williams' Fruits of Labor was medicine. And I think that so many times we don't take care of ourselves in the way we take care of so many other people, everybody, not just moms. I'm literally asking you to take care of yourself. I'm so proud of so many of my friends and so honored to know them because they're already doing it. But here I am just reminding you that medicine, okay, vitamin C, we can put it in our mouth and we can do all these things, but do not forget what stokes your fire, whatever that is.
It could be watching Mr. Rogers. I don't care what it is, but you need to stoke your inner fire right now, and you need to make sure that that you keep yourself inwardly strong and relax. I said at the beginning of this post, I had a rough week. I had all the symptoms of that thing that's going around. I did not take a test. I'm not confirmed. But I had the fever. I had the cough. I had everything. I'm not ashamed to say that. I don't know, you know, what it is. I could have just had a spring cold. But it slowed me down. And I did get through it after 5 days. And I took it very, very seriously. And I completely pounded my body with vitamins and everything. So I'm just sharing that with you. When the sun is out and you're doing whatever it is that you think you need to do, just take that half an hour or that hour and sit in the sun and feel the goodness of it, along with the music that you love so much, whatever it is. All right. So the redheaded Italians were earlier. We have another beautiful skit. August Gladstone, Josh Gladstone, and Kate Muth, neopolitical cowgirls. One quick thing I want to talk to you. Sorry, I forgot about this, and I shouldn't have. It's so, so important. Can you see that? Damn it. Where is it? Oh, sorry, guys. It's food. We're going to work on that. It's about the East End Food Pantry, the clamshell. Look, my nose just changed. Boop, 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 boop. Okay, here comes another one from August, Kate, and it's the Quiet Italians this time.
How was your day today, Tony Jr.?
It was fine. Normal, I guess.
Did you go to church?
I stopped by. I said hi to the pastor. I like to make sure that the collection is up and running successfully. It's not, because it's so awkward.
Did you sign up for your altar boy dates that you're supposed to be serving with Father Mulcahy?
Yeah.
Because you need to get in some of those altar boy dates, you know. Mm-hmm. You had some penance to do from the last couple of confessions you went to.
Right. Speaking of confessions, I did kill a man today. I whacked him outside the church. That's kind of why I stopped by.
You whacked a guy outside of a church?
You whacked a guy?
Yeah. He owed Paulie Ponzinelli money. And Polly's my friend, so I figured I'd do him a favor.
Well, what brought that up? What was the conflict?
I just said he owed him money, and I'm Polly's friend. He's given me a ride to swim lessons before, so I figured why not just go and do this guy a solid. Because clearly, the guy I killed, I don't know his name, but he wasn't paying up.
Huh.
I'm assuming he was the right guy. Given the screen.
So what happened after that?
Well, I left. Walk around for a little bit.
Did you return that library book of mine I asked you to return?
No, I didn't. I'm sorry. Hmm.
Damn it.
I think.
Can I ask you one little thing?
Why don't you pick up your mother's dry cleaner? What the fuck's the matter with you? She wanted you to go to the library and a dry cleaning?
I needed him to do two things for me today.
Why didn't you do that?
I got sidetracked.
You're sidetracked? You gotta get your priorities straight. Yeah, whatever. You're whacking guy, but what is it?
I'll do it tomorrow.
Give me that. Give me
all right, fine. Do it tomorrow, but don't forget this
not
time.
Forget.
For fuck's sake.
Give
me Jesus
wine.
Christ.
You know what? Don't get to drink the wine when you don't do what I say you're supposed to be doing.
That's
two
right.
Little things is all
two
I
things,
to
right? What
That's
was
it.
The library and
library
the dry cleaning?
Library and the dry cleaning.
What's the matter with
That's
you?
All I needed from you.
This is really a lot for me.
A lot for you, it's a lot for me, because now my book's going to be late, and my blouse isn't going to be ready for church tomorrow.
I can't be at this table
That's
anymore. I gotta go whack off.
Always with the whacking.
That might be the line of the night, which is always with the whacking. Ladies and gentlemen, we have been together for almost 2 hours now. I swore this was going to be an hour. We've been together for 2 hours, you and me. The Gladstones in the house, whacking one way or the other. Always you, with always with the whacking. I'm gonna take you out with a Bonnie Grice, but there's very good chance that it's gonna go to black because I'm a criminal with the FCC right now. You, always with the whacking. I know. It is honestly a great t-shirt. You, always with the whacking. You want to keep going? You want to just keep going and just talk amongst us with our comments? Oh, shit. I have to extend the organizing contest winner for another week. I'm sorry. I have to. I can't do it proper. If I had to just pull one out of the hat, I'm going to say that Colleen gets the Crisco if I decide. You know what? I'm going to decide. I just would like to put the images up, but I didn't have a chance because I was really feeling crap this week. So I'm going to say Colleen's the winner of the Crisco, the clams, or the coffee. But we're going to have another organizing tidy-up party next week. And everybody that didn't win can automatically be in that. So if you've sent me your tidy-up photos and they did not win this week because Colleen Paluba kicked your ass, then you're automatically going to go into the next week, the next round, unless you have something else you want to tidy up. Crisco's, coffee, clams. You want the Crisco? I'm impressed, Kyle, because I would take the Crisco too. Because at the end of this goddamn thing, the frying oil is going to be worth about $27 a pound. Can we talk while we're all still together about what we're thinking for next week? Are we going Caribbean? Are we going Thai? Where are we going to go next week? Where do you want to go? Where can I take you? Where can I take you? I'm going to feel better. I feel all right. Tomorrow I'm going to feel like shit because I drank half a bottle of wine. But that's all right. France, Irish, Chinese, seafood. I do like the seafood factor. I don't like having people that get out of their house. Someplace warm. I was thinking like Caribbean. Racist with the Thai. Get the fuck out, Larry David. How you doing? Irish, I have dozens of potatoes. I know, Bahamas, that's what I was thinking. Caribbean, could have a little Winston Irie, you know? Jamaican man, reggae. You did work hard for that, Crisco, Colleen. You did. Ooh, Western Grill. I do like that. Puerto Rico. Ashley, we could all adopt puppies. Speaking of which, I want to talk about our food pantry. Let me see if I can add this. Can I add that? Oh my goodness, did it go on? We're doing a $5 food pantry drive, and it's for East End Cares. And I'm going to put it on my Instagram thing. But what I want you to know is that 100% of the money goes to Ecuador. I like that. To the pantries, all right? So we're going to really start needing to rally for that. And I'll be mentioning that again. But the graphic is up. Ashley Gardner with that fabulous graphic right there, I have to say. If you want to make a donation, go to clamshellfoundation.org. Clamshellfoundation.org. And everyone's going to get it, all right? Everyone, hopefully the Meals on Wheels, because Bill Becker, I know you work hard with that. East End Cares also is another one. We can raise money. And I want to make mention of that, but I'm going to take it off now, because now's our time to not worry too much about it. Now's our time to be together and listen to Italian music and decide what fucking food we're going to make next week. Clams and potatoes is not a style of food, Anne-Marie McCoy. Corky, come on. I'm thinking Caribbean. I'm thinking Caribbean. I'm feeling Caribbean. Like reggae. We can go wherever we want. Little jerk chicken wings.
Right?
Island flavor. That is good. Baked beans and hot dogs. Steve Paluba could make baked beans and hot dogs into a Caribbean style. I think he could. Into eating again with the T-bone. She just will not let go of the grilling. Pina coladas. I do like that. I do like that. Football food from No Dig. Clams and potatoes again. Tropical evening. We're trying to escape here. Cook your food that's about to cook your food that's about to go bad night. Chicken roti. All right. I hear you loud and clear. Tofu and kale. Kiss my butt. Right. See, that's what I'm thinking. Caribbean rum punch. We could also do. Oh, you know what we could do? Exactly. A little. Well, Jimmy Buffett, Margarita Village. We could do crock pot night. What do you think about that? Has everybody got a crock pot? Let me see. You got some crock pots out there? What do you think? I'm not getting any crock pot responses. Always down with a crock pot and Instapot. Okay. Tailgate. I like it. Oh, God, it's getting hard. Annie, what is yup? I need your, like, intake. Oh, shit. Now my teeth are getting, like, the wine. Now my teeth are getting that winey stain. Ooh, so glad I'm not driving home. I don't drink and drive, by the way, ever. Okay, no pot. Slow cooking. Crotch? You know what I say to crotch? I say... nipple man's a scratch. That's what I say. But I'm going back to Primavera. Okay. Crockpot? Crockpot night. Crockpot Caribbean. We just started a brand new genre of food. Crockpot Caribbean. What food would Nipple Man want? Nipple Man would most likely like football food. Oh, he would like nipple food, football food. Breast milk. Carrie, new contest idea. Show us a photo of your oldest expired food item. Listen, you try feeding 5 people 3 meals a day every goddamn day. You try doing that. Chicken breasts? We could have chicken night. Cheese doodles for Nipple Man. What would Nipple Man look like? Hold on, let's take a look at him. I'm going to look at him and then I'm going to decide. What does a man like that? He likes beer. Hold on. Let me give you a full. Hold on. I'm breaking. Oh, yes. Ooh. What do you like to eat, Mr. Nipple Man? Do you like to eat, drink your beer from glass or from a can? What do you like to eat, Mr. Nipple Man? Do you like to eat chicken or crock pot? All right, I gotta make a call. He definitely does drink. Oh, you need something, John Chimples? Do you need something? Here. Here's your nipple, all right? There's your nipple, John Chimples. Right there. You need a little nipple? We all need a little nipple every now and then. You know? What are we gonna do? We can't touch each other's nipples right now, so we have to touch each other through the screen. Oh my god. All right. I'm gonna say Crock-Pot Caribbean. That way, if you don't have a crock pot, you can still make Caribbean. Island theme. Take us away. You know, Inda, you will be mayor of this town before you die with an answer like that. Potluck? It's a good answer, you motherfucker. It's a good answer, because everybody can do what they want. What the hell is that on my head? All right, sorry. Cat food casserole. Carrie, you're not going to get what's left over. Can I just tell you that secretly this is kind of my favorite part of the show? When we get that, and there's a chance I might do Clam Woman again, because now I'm feeling it. You know, I might. And we have a dance thing from Bonnie Grice, but I didn't get the rights to the music, so it's gonna go state. It's gonna go black again, and now I'm gonna get arrested 5 times. Which, if you know me, prior to COVID-19, not probably get arrested. Afraid of getting arrested. Crockpot Caribbean, bastards. Crockpot Caribbean, which means Crockpot / Caribbean. Or I might just make it, I might just go Caribbean. I don't know. I gotta think about it. Crockpot's too good to do half, you know? So what do we want to talk about right now? Anybody planting any seeds? Carl's, I'm talking because you said talk me to sleep, and since you've got, you know, 9 lives, I... Ooh, Tiger Man. I haven't seen Tiger Man. But here, you want to hate me? Do you want to hate me? I've never seen Game of Thrones, so I have, like, all 9 seasons to watch whenever I want to. You know, I'm going to get there eventually, but yes. I don't even know. I know there's a dragon. Game of Thrones? Don't know. Growing scallions. What are you growing? I'm going to grow some, I have pumpkins, and I have sunflowers. That's what I'm starting this week. You know what's going to happen, Ashley? I'm going to start watching Game of Thrones, and then I'm going to have a Game of Thrones one, and we're all going to have to dress up as Game of Thrones. Okay? We are also... Oh my god, I'm realizing it just came to me. Do you know what we're doing next week? We're having Halloween Caribbean. We're dressing up in Halloween, all of us. Yes, we are. We are gonna get dressed up in our Halloween costumes, and we are going to eat together Caribbean crockpot luck. Caribbean crockpot luck. There's your answer. Sometimes it takes an entire thing, but next week is Halloween week. And you know who would love that? Who's going to love Halloween week so much? I'm going to get him dressed up. You take your guesses at what Nipple Man is going to be. You can take your guesses, but it's going to be good. Because nobody loves Halloween like this bitch right here. All right? Nobody. All right? You just, yeah. You want a little nip? With the slow Italian music? I can't wait to see what I dress Nipple Man. I'm more excited to see what Nipple Man is for Halloween than what I'm gonna be, because I've got a whole goddamn basement full of Halloween costumes. In fact, if Armageddon does come, or the apocalypse, and you want to dress up as chicken when the meteor is hurtling towards us, you come to my house. I will have you covered, so. Now, what you may not know is that I lived in Italy for a year. And I was 19 years old. And, that's a good one. Nipple Man Elvis. So good. Venus on the Clamshell. I was an incredibly young, idealistic 19-year-old girl. And I read a book by Ayn Rand and, it was called The Fountainhead. And for the first time, I understood, I felt completely understood. And so when it came to getting a stage name, I could not become Nancy Fountainhead, even though it was a superior book to Atlas Shrugged. But I picked Atlas from Ayn Rand. That's right. So there's a little Italian heritage for you right now. And if you've never read Fountainhead, now's a good time. It's a little crazy and whatever. It has its faults. But for a 19-year-old girl who felt completely misunderstood, it did its job. Fountainhead Project is a better name than the Nancy Atlas Project. Probably one of my greatest failings. You know what's happening right now? I'm going to the other side. Yeah, I'm just a little bit more. Who's still with me? Are we like down to 3 people? Oh, we got 45 people still. All right, so I think we have decided now that it's Halloween Caribbean. We're gonna keep Crock-Pot for another time, okay? I think it's too good. Crock-Pot's too good. And unfortunately, I think we're gonna be here meeting for a few weeks. So Inda's going to bed. Good night, Inda. Thank you for your beautiful. I'm going to bed too. Thank you all for tuning in. Thank you for being so generous. I do usually play acoustic through this, but couldn't do it this week. So I hope you enjoyed the videos. Same time, same place, 8 o'clock on Saturday. I've always loved the underdog hour though, so I'll probably be moving this at some point to like a Thursday or something. Saturday's too hot and slick. Doesn't work for me, you know? Thank you. You feel better too. The other thing I was going to say to you is if you don't feel good, take good care of yourself and don't freak out, all right? Unless you have chest pains, don't freak out. Thank you so much. Love you guys. Good night. And we will see you next week. We're going to have Bonnie Grice take us out with a dance tune right now. And if it goes to black, oh well. Oh, hold on.
Hi, this is Ryan Williams reporting on the current state of our superheroes. Speaking with us now, you all know him, you all love him, Batman!
Hey, everybody. Oh, hi, everybody. It's Super Clam. Super Clam Lady. Clam Lady. I was Shucka Girl last week, but I've been homeschooling my children for 2 weeks, and I very quickly became Clam Lady.
I think we're having some technical difficulties. Clam Lady?
Yeah, we're like a second tier. We're second tier. You've never heard of us because we're like a second tier. We got Taco Man, Bad Chucky. There's a whole bunch of us you don't know about. We just kind of, we're in the shadows. We're not as famous as the big guns, you know. But we're here. We're here.
Clam Lady? You're not a superhero. I've never heard of you.
I can take clams and I turn into a seagull. And then I whip my head really fast and they become, these little fuckers become like bullets. They're unbelievable. They slice you in the head. But I'm a superhero on the East End.
East End of Long Island? All right, Clam Lady. What exactly do you do?
So often what'll come in the news is that somebody's driven into a jetty or a pier in broad daylight. And you could say to yourself, what? How the hell did somebody take a boat and drive it into a pier in the middle of the day? I don't understand, with all the radar and all. Well, that's because a crazy seagull. Wah! Throw the clam, 75, 80, sometimes 90 when I'm having a good day, miles an hour, hits the head. And all the last thing that bastard, that drinking bastard sees is a seagull, a rabid seagull coming at it at 70 miles an hour. And he takes a boat and, you know, headed for a jet ski or something, whatever. Oh, he does that and bam, he goes right into the jetty. Takes him out every time. Nobody's hurt. That's just an example of my work.
Clam Lady, are you busy right now? How have things been on the streets?
You know, I basically will be go. Oh my God. It's my brother. He's just like calling me right now. God, so stupid. All the superheroes, just, you're going to hate this, but they're partying because they're like immune to this thing. But anyway, well, listen, be safe. Don't drive your boat drunk, because you know what? I'm going to come at you and I'm going to take you out, is basically what. You're going to die and you're going to look like an idiot on top of it, because who drives a boat into a jetty? Who? In the broad daylight. I'll tell you who does it. A victim of Clam Lady. That's who. Peace out.
Well, thank you, Clam Lady. You're not who we expected, but I hope everyone on the East End is staying home and staying safe. All right, this is Ryan Williams reporting from Metropolis.